what we're about is exactly what y'all guys are doing. Is exactly what y'all speaking of. What we're about is taking the neighborhoods back and bringing them back to the people. So people can own their own neighborhoods. Because people do not own their own neighborhoods anymore. You know, they don't own any of the property. They don't own any of the stores. And they have, and because of this, the community itself doesn't have any political leverage, any kind of power. They can't become economically independent, nor do they have any kind of political power. And this is why schools get closed and nothing can be done about it. This is why community centers get closed and nothing can be done about it. And this is why there's a lot of poverty and low self-esteem within with the youth, because they don't really have anything that they can be proud of and say that's theirs. So Occupy the Hood is exactly what it sounds like. Occupy your own neighborhood, or take it back from those who have occupied it from you. So this is one of the reasons why, you know, and Malik can talk to you more about this, is why we spearheaded the 477. The reason why that was so important is because not so much the building itself or Queen Mother herself, although Queen Mother, I love Queen Mother, she raised me, that's the sort of. So, but what I mean is why it's important is because it's supposed to be an example and a model of what we want to do throughout New York City and then, you know, the country.
You got a question?
No, I just agreeing.
Oh, right. With the country, we also did some things in Queens, you know, with the foreclosure of the houses and our campaign and what we're trying to do out there as far as because a lot of things that's going on is that there's all these foreclosed houses, and even the banks don't know who own these mortgages. Mm. So there's these foreclosed houses where nobody's living in, and you can't even really sell them because nobody knows who owns them. You know, well, I'm sure they know, but you know, it's beneath the paperwork so that nobody can buy them. And again, we all know what that's for, is to make space for different companies to build mega stores and, you know, to gentrify the neighborhood in a way and you know, to push the people that live there out somewhere else, where they go, nobody knows, and we just want to stop that.
Where are you based at, in Harlem or?
Queens.
You're based in Queens.
Queens.
Yeah, we're actually Jamaica Queen. We're in 20 actively in 20 states. We got them in Florida taking houses back. But what I wanted to bring out about Occupy 477, beneath the paperwork and all of that, is they're being very aggressive with Queen Mother, and that's why we're there. Where they're like hinting that the wires are no good and it can catch fire and things
probably
of that nature. You know what I mean? So. They have people living in the basement that don't supposed to live in the basement, that's tearing up the boiler. So, I mean, for lack of a better word, we up there for the muscle. Like, nothing's gonna happen to Queen Mother while I'm breathing. And it's really that serious. It's really something out of a movie, how they're trying to do or even just do the tenants on each other. So, I don't have any political stance on it all, but you're not gonna get somebody that look like me out of a building if I got something to do with it.
And what it is, it's an idea of communalism, where the where people in the neighborhood, we just have to back each other up. You know, I remember when they was buying all the houses in my neighborhood, and I mean, don't get me wrong, the money is tempting, you know, and everybody wants to run, and they come and they'll buy it with cash. They'll come to your door and they'll say, here, we got cash, but the problem is that, you know, not everybody wants to leave. You know, not everybody in the neighborhood wants to leave, but what it does is when you get these exoduses, and then you put the people that are already there in this position where they can't afford to leave. You know, right. So it's just important that, you know, the sense of community, I think it was somewhere along the line, has been lost. That the community is a family, and
what part of Queens you live?
Jamaica Queens. So, you know, and we just want to reinforce that so that we can keep what we have, and we could actually make it better. And you know, just to have a and at the end of the day, it is about the kids, because it's a generational thing. It's something that you want to leave to your kids. You want to be able to leave a better community than when you had with your kids. But you don't have to leave the community. You can just build your community up to where you want it to be. So you never really have to leave. Because what happens is you leave, and then the gentrifiers come, and they take your neighborhood, and now your neighborhood is hot again. And now you want to move back to the neighborhood. And you can't afford it.
They try to get everybody to come to the meetings that they supposed to come to the meeting. But they need to come out to the meeting. They can go to the number man, they can play lotto, they go to the liquor store, they can come to the meeting. The meeting ain't but an hour.
You're right, but you know what we found? You know what we found?
I'm gonna say one thing. In the number place, because I play the numbers too.
I'm gonna let him speak.
I just want Malik, we still have another speaker here. Malik.
What?
You're gonna speak, right?
Oh no, I mean, he speaks for me.
That's my partner.
But I mean, I agree to everything he's saying, and I literally want to take the hood back. I mean, this is, I'm not.
You want to work on the muscle part?
I mean, whatever y'all need. We have. I work with different organizations. We have lawyers. We have lawyers at our disposal. We have organizations at our disposal. It's just that right now we're in the process of. All the people that's making promises, we're going to
make sure they keep them.
And we just came from Detroit, and we're working with people there on urban gardens and things like that. So it's really.
Well, I know about them.
We try to do whatever we can with a limited amount of resources.
Okay.
We got a whole lot of time, so we're going
to
get it done.
That's what I wanted to hear.
I want to get the Detroit information.
There's somebody over here.
Over here?
There's two people, I guess.
I want to say something. You know, I hate you say that. You know, I want you to understand something. It's always two sides, and many times it's more than two sides in every situation. Right. Now, I know about that situation you're talking about, and it's clearly nothing like that. I mean, by fact. And when you say about muscle, that kind of perturbs me because that's what we're about, Reebok intelligence right here. Reebok communication.
Okay, brother.
Okay, wait a minute now. Just let me say, okay? It's not about no muscle. It's about what's true. It's about what's legal. It's about what's law. Okay, so we're talking about mind, not no muscle, because you don't have enough muscle to stand up by yourself to do anything. That's why we have a coalition with each other. We have muscle when we come together.
Okay, brother.
So let's understand that. So we have to have a collective vision. And that's how you deal with issues, by listening to all sides. And then you come to a common agreement, and then you eradicate that particular problem. But it's not by muscle. It's from the mind. So I just want to, just say that.
I think he said that when he said he's part of Occupy the Hood throughout the whole country. They've got him in Florida.
Can I clarify what I'm saying? We have to clarify here because I don't want you to think that any means that I'm a brute, but what I'm telling you is that this woman feels unsafe in this house.
I'm not going to talk about that here.
I know, but you brought it up.
Hey, we can have a discussion, but it is one person at a time. Mm-hmm. Akil, have you finished?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Now.
Thank you. I don't know the issue, but I know just in talking, I think it does a disservice to any movement when it's just one. In this case, I heard a building. There are many, many buildings in Harlem that are so affected. And you bring power, you make power in a statement. When your other neighbors, you do not ignore them. And so, as he suggested, don't know the issue. There may be controversy. I don't know. It does not matter. But it should not be a movement based on one building. If there is an opportunity to occupy, there should be many. Yes, ma'am.
What is your name? That was in a proposal that was passed. We have a global view of the building, and it was not, number one, in this particular building about personalities, but it was about saving the building as a community asset. And that any decisions or conclusions reached would be based on research and a discussion with all parties. Akil, did you understand that from the resolution that we just voted on?
We passed the proposal. It's here.
Okay.
Excuse me, just a second.
Yes.
All the buildings.
Why don't we have a stat? Excuse me.
To be clear, we're working with a simple philosophy in a sense of one block at a time, one building at a time. But of course, this is about the whole thing all together, just what they're doing to tenants and residents all together. That's what this is about. It's not really about just that one building. That's the model for what we want to do all over the place. Another thing, when we say bully, we're not talking in a brutish kind of way. When we say bully, meaning we will not be intimidated. All right, we will not be intimidated, and we will not be pushed around or pushed out. You know, and that's it, period. We won't sell out, period. And that's what we mean when we say bullying. It's not bullying like you're gonna, you know, knock somebody over the head. Although need be, but I'm just kidding. We don't want to knock nobody over the head, but we just will not be pushed around. We will not be bullied. You know, and that's right. It.